Hey everyone, we are so excited about doing this video with you. I'm together here with Ilze and Reino and Jon. And we want to do a video where we talk about the last Reformation. What is happening? Where do we come from and where are we going? There's many people out there who are asked Christians about what is the last Reformation? Is it the title of a book? Is it a ministry or organization? Or is it a movement? And I'll start with answer that question. The Last Reformation is everything. The Last Reformation actually started some years ago as a book. Or we not say the Last Reformation starting because there was no Last Reformation that time. But some years ago, I wrote a book called Den Sidste Reformation. It was in Danish. And later we translated it to English and it became The Last Reformation. And in the book, I talk about why I call it the Last Reformation, because we have seen different reformation through the ages, but we need a new reformation. And I hope that this new reformation will be the last one, where we come back to the life we read about in the Book of Acts. So I did a book called The Last Reformation. Then later I did like a website and a ministry called The Last Reformation. And it was like a ministry and an organization in Denmark, and it had been growing and growing and growing. And now the Last Reformation is much more than just a ministry, it's much more than an organization, it's also a movement. And we want to, in this video, explain what the Last Reformation is and some of the changes that is happening in the Last Reformation. Because I believe, we all believe, that we need to change all the time, because when things grow, new things develop and new issues come up and new things need to be dealt with. So I got this picture some time ago, and I think that explained really good what we see the Last Reformation is. If we look at the Last Reformation here, we see the Last Reformation as like a big, big era that is breaking through a lot of strongholds. It's breaking through a lot of tradition of man, traditions from the churches. It's breaking through a lot of lies when it comes to what salvation, doctrine, and discipleship is. And I really see that the Last Reformation, and now we're not talking about the book, now we're talking about this organization or this also part of the movement. This is like a big, strong era that's breaking through. And the Last Reformation, if you look at this like this, the era is, this is the online pioneer training school we have. This is the pioneer training school or schools, because there's more and more pioneer training schools that are starting. So this is right now 24 videos. This is a 3-week school that is in different countries. Then we have the TLR movies. We actually have more. We have also the 7 Days Adventure with God movie. So right now we have 2 movies and the third one is coming out very soon. Then we have the YouTube channel that is growing a lot. Then we have the TLR Kickstart. This is Jon and other people are doing TLR Kickstart, and he's going to tell about that in a short time. And then we have the Jesus Hotel, where we now have 1 Jesus Hotel in Denmark that is like a Jesus Hub, a center where people come and get trained and is sending out again. And God has been speaking to us about starting 5 of those, 5 Jesus Hotels. There would be like a Jesus Hub, where people come and get trained and send out, a center where we send out apostolic teams, a center where the family come together and get trained and so on and so on. Says and don't like what we are doing. Says and really don't like what is happening right now. And he has been trying to come in to destroy this with different ideas and different things. And what we see very clear is that if we want to break through and see this become the movement God have called it to be, then this era needs to be strong. This era needs to have a very, very high standard. But the movement in itself is much bigger than this era. Because there is people who are somehow part of the Last Reformation in that way that they connect with us in that way, that they love what God is doing, but they are not like doing it the same way we are doing it. For example, when we started to do the Kickstart some years ago, more people took that idea, make it their own, and now there's many, many people all over the world who are doing Kickstarts. They're not exactly part of the Last Reformation, but they take the idea and do Kickstarts. Do we love this? Of course we love it. Because this is the whole idea. We are not here to build TLR. We are here to build the kingdom. We are here to bring build God's kingdom. But we also know the best way we can bring the kingdom here to earth is to continue focus on this era, to be strong, to break through. And with the Kickstart, people are doing Kickstart, we love it. People are now taking the gospel the way we preach it with repentance, baptism, water and the Holy Spirit and casting out demons. They're not directly a part of TLR, but they take it, we love it. We actually love it that everything we do is for free. The movies is for free. I don't know of many others who do professional movies and give it up for free. The online pioneer school is for free. Everything we can do like there is for free. The Kickstart is for free. Of course, we take up a gift to cover the cost, but we want to make it for free. Why? Because this is the way to spread it. But what we have seen is that some people have tried to misuse the name of the Last Reformation. Some people have said, no, TLR is the movement. I can deal with it the way I want it. So now I can take TLR name and call everything I do for the Last Reformation. And this is why we do this video, because if everyone start to just take the name, the TLR, and make do whatever they want to, suddenly this era is not strong anymore. And we will not be able to break through. And Ilze and Jon can say a little more about that, why it become a problem when it comes to a little with the Kickstart, but especially the schools and other things, and then we will continue.
So the vision for the Pioneer Training School has always been to train disciples to make new disciples. And the vision is still staying the same. We are very excited about the Pioneer Training Schools. And as Torben mentioned, there's more schools that have started and starting soon. But as Torben said, it's important to have a high standard in this Pioneer Training Schools. The focus has never been to train people to run their own schools in these three-week schools. Students come and we equip them to be effective to make disciples out in their homes or churches, wherever they fellowship. So it's very important for us to keep the standard high, to say that when people come to a Pioneer Training School, that they've received the same standard than what the Last Reformation stand for. We've had a lot of questions of people that want to use the name Pioneer Training School for the Last Reformation and just take the teachings, which is good, but have their own schools. The problem with this is we need to have accountability. If something goes wrong, the complaints normally come to the Last Reformation Denmark. So this is why we just need to make sure that people that run schools are people that have been trained and that work with us to do the schools.
Yeah, we find it's really important as well. If you go to a school in Holland, that you get the same Pioneer Training School that you would in Denmark. Or if you go to the States, you get the same training you would get in wherever the other schools are, Canada. So it's to make sure that if you attend a Pioneer School, for those people out there that want to attend a Pioneer Training School, you know exactly what you get. You know that if you tick and you say, I have attended a Pioneer Training School, there is no difference between your training and the people that went to Denmark. There's no special place to go, so to speak, that the training is the same, that the people doing the training is actually qualified. They're actually working together with a team that's not some one-man band trying to build his own kingdom. It is a team of people coming together, training and equipping the body to go out and make disciples of Jesus. The focus of the Pioneer Training Schools is the gospel. Now we get a lot of people coming to us that, yes, I want to do a 10-day school, I want to do a 16-day school, I want to do a weekend school. There's many different things they want to do, and like everything, we put our teachings out and it's for free, use it. But if it's not a 3-week school and it's not part of our team that's been trained to do these schools, then just don't call it a Pioneer Training School, because it's not. Just be honest, say this is the teachings we're using, but it is not a Pioneer Training School. But take the material, take it, use it. We are working in the kingdom of God, as Torben said.
I've said none of us is here to build the Last Reformation. We are really here to build the Kingdom of God. And maybe if you've not seen it yet, go on YouTube and see the video where I told about how I actually stepped out 1.5 years ago and gave it over, but then I came back again. Because that shows our heart. We don't live for the Last Reformation. We really live for God. We want to build the Kingdom of God. But we also get a lot of complaints because people get disappointed because they think they come to something, they have seen a movie, they have seen our teaching, and then they come to something that is called TLR, and they get something very, very different. And that's why we need to do this video, because we want to have a high standard. Mm-hmm. We want to do it, and we have experience with the Kickstart, with the Pioneer Training School, and the Kickstart especially, that people like the name TLR because it's now a brand. If you use it, more people will come because they've seen the movies and all of that. And that is fine, but it's not for every man to use. Every man can do a kickstart. Every man can do teaching and take the teaching we use and set up their own schools. It's for free. Take it. Make it your own. But if you want to call it the Last Reformation, then you have to be connected with us. And that is not to control, that is to keep the standard. And that is to keep it pure. Because we want a pure gospel, we want it all. And Jon is one of those who are actually doing the Last Reformation kickstarts. And he can just say a little about what a TLR kickstart is.
Yeah, TLR kickstart is really simple. It's all about go and equipping people where people are coming for this kickstart seminar, and where we have a 7 core teachings where we talk about the first teaching, where we talk about Christian and disciple, what it really means to be a disciple, to go out and do what Jesus commands us to follow him. And then after that, we talk about Luke 10, what is our platform? And that we see in Luke chapter 10, where Jesus talk about the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few, and we should go out to find a personal peace and so on. And then after we have we're teaching about how to heal the sick, where we are not only called to preach the gospel, but to preach the gospel and to heal the sick. And then after we go out on the streets and kickstarting people how to do it. And then after we have also teaching about what is the gospel, how to be born again, where Jesus talking about that in John chapter 3 and so on. And then we look about how to be born again, where we talk about repentance, to repent, to turn away from our sin, get baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of our sin, and then we shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Where we take a look at all of these three steps, what it really means, how important it is as a part of the gospel, as a part of salvation. And then after that, we often show how to share the gospel, where we call it cups and cookies, where we show it in a really, really simple way to share the gospel, where you can try to show that you can share everywhere you are. You can share when you are in the kitchen, your living room, in a coffee shop. It's a really, really simple, but really radical how to share the gospel. And then after, we have another teaching where we talk about spiritual warfare and casting out demons. That we are not only called to preach the gospel only or heal the sick only, but to also cast out demons. And there we talk about a little bit like, look at what Jesus is saying about these things and what his first disciple did. And not only them, but that we are also called to do the same thing, to go out and to cast out demons. And the last teaching is that we talk about the four grounds, the four soils. What grounds are we in? For example, we'll talk about the ground number one, the ground number two, the ground number three, and ground number four. Where we talk about that we are called to be the good grounds, the ground number four. So this is actually really simple teaching, but radical. So yeah.
And when Jon do it, he see the same result I see, because it's actually the power in the word, it's the power in the gospel. And what we have seen when I started to do the kickstarts, there was 20, 30 people, but people saw the fruit, went out, invited friends, and other people came. And therefore, it has been growing and growing and growing, and Jon's experience is growing a lot, and Fabian is doing TLR Kickstart, and there is other people who's doing TLR Kickstart. And we want to keep it like that. So when people come to a TLR Kickstart, they know what they get. So when they go out, Next time there is a TLR kickstart in their area, they know what it's about, so they can invite friends and neighbor and other people have heard the good fruits of it, so more people come. So we don't want to change it, we want to say, and that counts for me also, when I do a TLR kickstart, it's like this. I can also not change it and just say, hey, I want to do something so different. There is something we need to have a high standard of. Because God here entrusted us something beautiful here, and we want to be faithful with what God has given us. And Jon are doing an amazing job in this, and more people later will start to step out and do TLR Kickstart. When that is said, again, you are welcome to do your own Kickstart. You are welcome to set up Kickstarts, and we have our map and network and things we can use, but if it's not like Jon have described, and if you're not connected with us, it's not a Last Reformation Kickstart. I hope you understand our heart in it. Our heart is really have a high standard. We need to be accountable to each other in that way, because we are learning. Satan don't like us, there's a lot of attacks, and we want to live a holy life. We want to work together, and we want to see something that's healthy. There's many stories today of ministries and movements that go wrong, and often it comes to control, it comes to money, and it comes to sex. Those three areas is areas where people fall again and again and again. And therefore, we need to have a high standard. And we have seen people in the beginning who wanted to be part of the Last Reformation to build their own kingdom. Mm. Not because they want to submit in a healthy way, not because they want to preach the full gospel, they want because they want their name and they want to build a ministry. And therefore we need to take care of what God has given us here. Also when you talk about to continue doing what we are doing, because like if we have issues of people who use the Last Reformation TLR name and send out something to ask for money, and people actually support thinking that they're giving money to us and helping us, but they're actually helping that person or that ministry. And we need people out there who believe in us and believe in what God has given us, because the free movies we are doing, maybe we give it out for free, but nothing is free. It's not free to do a movie. It actually costs a lot of money. I don't think people know how much it costs to do what we are doing, to give out those free movies and all of that. So we need people to just know who are they supporting. Therefore, we also encourage people who work with us, set up their own website. There is people who will connect with us, who are connected with us, who do TLR thing and have their own website where people can support them. And we don't have problem with that. We actually encourage people to do that, because then people know who they are giving to. And that is the thing. We just need to live in a light. We don't want to deceive people. We want people to know, now I'm supporting the Last Reformation as a movement to give out movies. Now we are supporting this ministry. Now we are supporting this ministry. Now we go to an event there and it's those people who are behind. So people don't get disappointed. So that is actually why we show this and why we want to make it even clearer in the future what the Last Reformation is, who's connected with the Last Reformation, and how we work together as the Last Reformation. I would say again, we love Jesus. Amen. It's all about making disciples. And how do you become part of the Last Reformation? If we talk about this, there's no membership, there is nothing you can sign on under. It's actually really a heart relationship. It really comes into having the same heart, the same DNA. We all love Jesus. We all love the simple truth. We all love the reformation of the church structure where we all preach. We all want to submit to one another. We all believe that the response to the baptism is the repentance baptism, water and baptism with the Holy Spirit. So all of those things, the disciple part, it brings us together. It makes us part of this family, and it's a relationship. That's also why we're going to change things with the map. We have the TLR map on our website, where at soon, in a month or two, we're actually going to start all over again. We're going to take all the green markers off the map and start all over. And the way we do it now is we are creating a system where it will not be controlled by one man, but where we as a team work together. So there will be, if three people who are green, they recommend somebody who should be green over a period of a half year, then that person become green. And then that person can actually recommend other people, and then they can become green. So we want to do it in a way where it can grow more with hard relationship, and not just like do, because we were too fast in the beginning to say, hey, he can preach the gospel, he can lead people to Christ, let's make him green. And we don't have a relationship, and suddenly people go off. And we hear about that in Denmark, that hey, your contact person, he said to me that I was already baptized as a baby, so I don't need to get baptized again. What is happening here? Sorry guys. So this is the reason we make this video. So I hope you understand our heart, and they can just end up with saying something each of them.
Yeah, we just want to invite you to the Pioneer Training Schools. It's changed my and Ilse's life and Jon's life as well. So many people out there. It's really effective. If you have 3 weeks in your schedule somewhere to sign up, it will change your life also.
And for those of you who can't attend, just watch the Pioneer School online, watch the movies, and then just go out and make disciples of Jesus.
Yeah. I just want to encourage you, those who haven't been part of this or seen in videos, or maybe you have, no matter what, just go for it and watching the teachings and so on, and participate for the Kickstarter Center where it is, wherever it is, if it's close in your city or your town, your country and so on. And then after, just go out and just live the life.
Amen.
Just live the life what we read in the Bible.
Yeah. And I'll end again and say that what is the Last Reformation? It was the title of a book. It's an organization, but it's a movement, or it's also creating a movement that way that is like a big arrow that breaks through those lies and strongholds. And we love when people take the truth and just run with it. No matter what we call it, it's about the kingdom. It's about seeing the kingdom of God grow. And there is many things we have already seen when it comes to the Kickstarter, when it comes to the gospel, when it comes to sharing the cups and cookies, when it comes to finding the personal peace. Things that God have used us to really get out again, but there's many things that need to happen yet, because we are still learning. So God bless you out there. Continue following us. And if you have questions, contact us. Otherwise, the best is to connect with us at a school. Come to a Kickstart with Jon or with me, and connect and get it under your skin, and let's work together. We are working on new things all the time. We will start with a school next year. There will come another school next year, a bigger school also, where we want to have more different kind of gifting in. We need businessmen. We need people who are good at computers. We need people who are gifted in other areas than maybe going out on the street. We need the whole body come together and work together so we can bear even more fruit. God bless you out there. Bye-bye.